your rights as a patient and informed consent. A patient who develops a complication blames his doctor. He goes to a lawyer to file a case, finds out from a senior medical consultant that the doctor was not negligent. Bad outcomes can occur in spite of good medical care.
All rise. Department 1 of Bandra Court is in session. Judge D'Souza is presiding. Please be seated.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Calling case number 420 of Mr. Lakhani and Mr. Dr. Joshi. Are both parties ready?
Ready, Your Honor.
Yes, Your Honor.
Please proceed.
Will the jury please stand up? Raise your right hand. Do each of you swear that you will fairly try the case before this court and that you will give a true verdict according to the evidence and instructions of the court? Please say, I do.
I do.
Please be seated.
Your Honor, Mr. Lakhani and Dr. Joshi, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, and to my colleagues, good morning.
Go.
Your Honor, the defendant has been charged with the crime of providing incomplete information to her patient and performing a surgery which included a removal of the large intestine of the patient without his consent, thus violating the right of the patient to complete information and informed consent. The evidence I present to you will prove that the defendant is guilty as charged. Mr. Lakhani here approved of a surgery which included removal of his appendix only. After the surgery, he was informed that a part of his large intestine was removed as well. This violated the right of the patient, which states that a signed informed consent is required of the patient before his inclusion in any diagnostic or therapeutic treatment.
Your Honor, my client is presumed innocent until proven guilty. I am calling an expert in this field to give a detailed explanation about Mr. Lakhani's case.
The prosecution may call its first witness.
I would like to call Dr. Joshi as my first witness.
Please proceed.
Raise your right hand. Do you promise that the testimony you shall give in the case before this court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Please say, I do.
I do. The doctor must provide the patient all relevant information regarding the surgery along with its risks and benefits. And any alternatives, a rough overview of it, which will be understandable by the patient. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Since how long has Mr. Lakhani been coming to you?
About 2 years.
What was the cause of Mr. Lakhani's sickness?
He got appendicitis, which is the inflammation of the appendix.
And how was it treated?
Usually, in an inflamed appendix, if it bursts, it causes infection in the surrounding area, or in worst cases, a patient might even die. And the cause is usually unknown. It might be due to infection to the digestive tract or because of the blockage between the large intestine and the appendix.
Alright, and what caused you to remove a part of the large intestine of Mr. Lakhani?
The swelling had reached the large intestine, so it was important for me to save the patient, so I had to take it out.
And did you provide him with all the relevant information regarding it?
No, I hadn't. It was impossible at that time. The patient was unconscious.
Why was that so?
During the surgery, then I realized that the appendix is swollen and part is formed to the large intestine. So it would have proven fatal if I hadn't had the wound.
Thank you. I have no further questions.
Does defense have any question?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. The witness is excused. You may call your next witness.
I would like to call Mr. Lakhani as my next witness.
Please proceed.
Please raise your right hand. Do you promise that the testimony you shall give in the case before this court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Please say, I do.
I do.
What happened to you that made you visit Dr. Joshi?
There was a vague swelling, mild pain, and indigestion, for which Dr. Joshi prescribed a few medicines, but eventually the pain worsened. It shifted from my belly button to the right side of my abdomen. I suffered from continuous vomiting, diarrhea, and constipation. And eventually, Dr. Joshi diagnosed this to be appendicitis, for which he advised me to undergo a surgery.
Alright, and were you aware that a part of your large intestine was removed as well?
No, I was not informed about this. My patient rights were violated. She's a cheat!
Hey! Order, order! This is court, keep silence. The prosecution may proceed with further inquiries.
I have no further.
question.
Do you have any further question?
No, Your Honor.
The witness is excused.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Defendant may call next witness.
Your Honor, I would like to call Dr. Shroff as my next witness. He is a retired surgeon who specializes in these surgeries.
Okay, please proceed.
Please raise your right hand. Do you promise that the testimony you shall give in the case before this court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Please say, I do.
I do.
So could you explain your side of Mr. Lakhani's case?
I have read through the patient's medical history and reports. I have spoken to Dr. Doshi as well. I believe Dr. Doshi was guided for performing the operation because the appendix had infected the larger intestine as well, and it was a matter of life and death. If Dr. Doshi wouldn't have performed the operation, the patient could have died. And if it wasn't for Dr. Doshi's quick wit, the patient wouldn't have survived for sure. The patient was unconscious because of anesthesia, and so Dr. Doshi couldn't take the consent. Although it wasn't legal what Dr. Doshi did, but it was because of his quick wit that saved the patient. I am proud of such doctors.
Thank you, Doctor. What Mr. Shroff said shows that my client is not guilty. In fact, he saved Mr. Lakhani's life, so he should be grateful to her for that.
After considering the steps taken by Dr. Joshi and Dr. Shroff's witness and his expert's comment related to surgery, I hereby discharge Dr. Joshi of whatever accusation made against her.